Time to lace them up for the Tip-Off Lowdown. Brought to you by Prompt Physical Therapy next to Lakeshore Park in Bearden. And by the re-elect Tom Spangler for Knox County Sheriff Campaign Committee. Re-elect Sheriff Spangler. Let's head downtown for the Tip-Off Lowdown on the Big Orange Tip-Off Club. Now, here's your host, Gary Lowe.
Good morning and welcome to another terrific weekend of Tip-Off Lowdown. Big Orange Tip-Off Club members welcome another high-profile luncheon speaker this week who's achieved success in basketball with ties to the University of Tennessee. We'll have that keynote speech from here in downtown Knoxville in just a moment, but first, coming up on the show this morning, we'll have your personal invitation to join the Big Orange Tip-Off Club and high schoolers shine in the spotlight. All coming up on Tip-Off Lowdown. Now let's hear from our featured speaker at this week's Big Orange Tip-Off Club Luncheon.
John Fulkerson, what we've got. Everybody knows John. He's up from the Tri-City areas. John, I calculate you're at 167 games that you've played already. So and that's going to break a record. And I think you're close to the, or have you scored your 1,000th point yet?
Yes.
All right, so he's in the 1,000 point club, and that's a very high honor at the University of Tennessee, at any college at Division I. And he has the sixth best field goal percentage in school history. So let's welcome John Fulkerson. John?
Thank you guys for having me. It's really good to see all you guys. Like Coach said, we haven't really been able to get out and see the fans as much the past few years just because of COVID and everything, so it's really good to be here. I think you all may all know who I am, but if not, I'm John Fulkerson. I'm from Kingsport. This is my sixth year here. I played a lot of games here. I went to Dobbins Bennett High School in Kingsport, and then I went to Christ School in Asheville, North Carolina for 2 years. And just a little backstory about my coming here and how I got here. Growing up in Kingsport, it was a dream to always come to Tennessee and play here. I grew up, I think Chris Lofton was probably my favorite player growing up, and I like Wayne Chisholm a lot too. So growing up, I really admired those guys, really wanted to be just like him. And so it was always a dream to play basketball at Tennessee. But to be honest with you guys, when going through the recruiting process and finding a school, when Tennessee offered me, when Coach Barnes called me and offered me, I didn't commit right on the spot. I wanted to go somewhere that I liked the coaching, the coaches, the coaching staff, my teammates, the city, the community, everything. And so I went through the whole recruiting process, and it was kind of hard not to commit to Tennessee right as soon as they offered. It was really hard. But I went through it all, and after I came on my official visit, actually when I came on my visit, we were at, I'm pretty sure it was the Arkansas football game, and you know, we were sitting in the recruiting seats right there in the end zone, and Eric Berry's cousin or little brother, he ran back the opening kickoff, and we were sitting right there and we watched it, and he ran it back, and it was my first ever Tennessee football game on my visit. I had never been to a Tennessee football game, and so when he ran back that kickoff, you know, Rocky Top was playing, there was over 100,000 people in there going crazy, and I really wanted to look to the coaches right then and there and commit on the spot, because I was like, man, like it can't get any better than this. So fast forward to today, you know, this is my sixth year playing, and actually let's backtrack to last year during the SEC tournament. When I was hit and injured during the SEC tournament against Florida. Before that, I had no intentions of coming back this year. I was going to pursue other opportunities playing basketball, wherever that may be. But because of that, I think that playing, that would have made it 2 years in a row that I was not able to play in the SEC tournament or the NCAA tournament, because the year before it was canceled because of COVID, and then I wasn't able to play in it last year. And so this opportunity was way too special to pass up on, playing here, playing for fans like Vol Nation and for my coaches and teammates, and just to wear the power tee again one more year. But to talk about this season, and especially last night, like Coach Schwartz said, last night was one of the best atmospheres in the country. Our students were lined up. I mean, I think it was noon when they started lining up for 9 o'clock tip, and I think that just goes to show you the passion that our fans have for this university and the fan base that we have and the support and love that we have from every single one of you guys. And on behalf of me and my teammates and all of our student athletes, we really, really appreciate all you guys, all you do for us. It's playing in that game last night, it's so easy to love this place so much more and more after last night. I've enjoyed my time at Tennessee here so much. I love here. I want to come back for my sixth season here. I might be the only player ever to play basketball 6 years at Tennessee. But I love it here. Like I said, the coaches, my teammates, this city, this community, it makes it all worth it. And, you know, Tennessee is so near and dear to my heart. I love Vol Nation. I love to represent the Power T. And I think something that makes it so close to home to me is that how much I looked up to people like Chris Lofton and Wayne Chisholm and those guys. And as a kid, middle school, high school, elementary school, I never in my wildest dreams would have thought that I would have been in this position, that I would have had this success, that I would even be here playing basketball. And so I just try to be a great role model and example for all these next generation of believers, for all these kids out there that, because you never know who's going to be the next Chris Lofton or Jordan Bone or Admiral Schofield or Grant Williams that's going to come through here. And so just trying to be a good example for those kids and know that if you just keep working hard, then good things will happen.
We'll have more of our keynote speech at this week's tip-off luncheon in just a moment. But first, with camaraderie and inside basketball info like this, why not join the club? Just go online and click on bigorangetipoff.com. Go to the membership page and fill out an application. You have the option of submitting the application online or downloading the application and mailing it in with payment. The Big Orange Tip-Off Club would love to have you. Why not join today?
Tip-Off Lowdown with the Big Orange Tip-Off Club is brought to you by Prompt Physical Therapy next to Lakeshore Park in Bearden and by the Re-Elect Tom Spangler for Knox County Sheriff Campaign Committee. Re-Elect Sheriff Spangler.
Who says quality can't be quick? From artwork to memorabilia, Express Frame can help you protect and show off your prized possessions. Same quality, same people, new name. Express Frame in the Commons Shopping Center on North Peters Road.
Take a tour of Big Orange basketball history at the Hoops Museum in North Knoxville. This nonprofit collection preserves UT men's basketball memorabilia. Historian R. Larry Smith shares more than 100 years of Vols, including the Ray Mears era, to today's team. Displayed are dozens of vintage Tennessee artifacts. Hoops Museum tours are free. Just bring a game program, ticket stub, or sports page to help our Larry Smith round out this historic tribute. Phone 865-679-4106 to plan your Hoops Museum visit.
Now let's hear more from our featured speaker at this week's Big Orange Tip-Off Club Luncheon.
I would say that our 2017, 2018, 2018, 2019, those two teams, the year we won the SEC championship, that team is very close. We accomplished a lot of things with SEC regular season championships, and then next year we're ranked number one in the country. And that team still talks every day to this point. And even though it was 2 or 3 years ago, we talk every single day. We were talking in the group chat last night, and all of them were really excited. You know, they all love beating Kentucky. We beat Kentucky a lot when they were here, and so they were all I think I might be the only active player in the group chat from then, and so they were all talking about the game. But man, the relationships that you make, especially when you make such great memories like winning the SEC championships and being number one ranked in the country, I mean, those are memories you can only dream of. And so that made that group of guys so close. And so I mean, in that group message, there's Grant, Admiral, Kyle, Bone, Bowden, Lamonte, Chris Darrington, James Daniels, Lamonte Turner. I mean, there's a lot of guys in there that we've just gotten so close over the years because of the memories we made here at Tennessee. And so, it's people always ask me, you know, who's my favorite teammate or what's the favorite team I've been on? And that's probably the hardest question I ever get because – you know, it's so hard to single out a certain team, especially a certain teammate. So I've been very lucky and very blessed to be able to be a part of some great teams and some even better teammates. I think the biggest thing is just going out and just trying to be myself and be myself, because I feel like a lot of people may look at me as, you know, John Fulkerson, the basketball player, but really I just want to be John Fulkerson, you know, just somebody's friend or just another person, or, you know, a person that's, you know, good in the community, things like that. I don't want to be, you know, put on another level or on another pedestal. I just want to be just like you guys, and be very personal to everybody. But I really enjoy talking to people and getting to know people. And I think outside of basketball, I think one of the biggest things I've learned from being at Tennessee is public speaking. Before I got to Tennessee, I would have been really nervous. I'm still nervous standing up here, but just public speaking is something that I think that has helped me in a lot of ways. And now I'm very comfortable doing it. For example, this morning I went and talked to a high school basketball team, and I think just showing them that if they continue to work hard and, you know, they put their minds and hearts to it, then, you know, there's no telling what you can accomplish. And just hopefully, like I said, being an encouragement and an example to especially high school, middle school students, that, you know, hopefully being somebody that they can look up to. There's countless memories on bus trips, plane trips, in the locker room, moments that we're gonna cherish for a long time. Actually, me and Josiah James were talking the other day, and we were literally in the floor in our locker room laughing at somebody. I can't remember who it was, and we were talking like, man, like we should really make a diary every day of just something that happens, because there's so many memories that we have in the locker room and on the court, whether it's you know, good things or bad things. Just write them down, because we're gonna look back when we're older and say, man, like, you remember when this happened or that happened, and we were literally doubled over laughing so hard, and we're like, man, like we're gonna miss these moments. We're gonna really need to remember these moments.
In 1931, Eccles West started selling Chevrolets in East Tennessee. And four generations later, the West Chevrolet family continues the tradition. We're proud of our rich history and Smoky Mountain heritage. We know our customers' needs and understand our role in the local community. Now, we invite you to visit our bright new dealership. And when you're ready for your next vehicle, come see us at West Chevrolet, where we try to treat every customer like a part of the family.
This is Julie for Old City Kitchens, inviting you to visit our new kitchen showroom located in the Old City in downtown Knoxville. Whatever your taste or budget, Old City Kitchens delivers the best cabinet value in East Tennessee. Whether you prefer traditional raised panel cabinets, rustic natural hickory cabinets, or the hottest selling shaker style cabinets, Old City Kitchens has a cabinet style for the most discriminating customer. So if you want a better kitchen at a better price, shop Old City Kitchens, making dream kitchens affordable. We'll see you in the Old City.
Tom Spangler, Knox County Sheriff, grew up in East Knox County. He's a graduate of Carter High School and an Air Force veteran who began his career in law enforcement as a corrections officer, working his way through the ranks from patrol, metro narcotics, training director, chief deputy, and overwhelmingly elected sheriff in 2018. Now with over 40 years of experience, Tom Spangler is running for re-election.
I'm Tom Spangler, your current Knox County Sheriff, and I'm running for re-election, and I'm asking for your vote.
On the girls' side, the postseason's already begun for our honoree today. This past Saturday night, she had 22 points in a win over top-seeded Lakeway Christian Academy. On Monday night, she had 10 points, 6 rebounds, and 6 assists in a region quarterfinal win. She's a 5'8 junior combo guard from CAK. Let's give a warm welcome to the girls' player of the week, Emily Wilson.
It means a lot. I'm really grateful and thankful to get this. I couldn't do it without my coaches and my teammates helping me, and I put in a lot of hard work for this, so it just means a lot. So our big thing this year has just been we over me, and I think we've done really good as a team accomplishing that. We play really hard, and we play together, and we put in a lot of work in the postseason to get here and to win. So. I don't know what I would do without basketball. I mean, it's brought me a lot of amazing friends and coaches and a lot of opportunities that I wouldn't have without it. So,
I believe Emily has some family here today, as well as head coach Abby Williams, so please make them feel welcome. Our boys player of the week, I got to see a couple of years ago. I started hearing rumblings of this undefeated team at Whittle Springs Middle, and we don't cover middle school teams very often, but I went out to see this kid play as an eighth grader and was already very impressed and polished with what he was able to do back then. And now here, a couple years later, he's a sophomore, recently named district MVP. He has helped Fulton to a 23-5 record. They have won 8 consecutive games. They knocked off Oak Ridge just the other night on the road in Oak Ridge. So I wanted to bring this young man down today, let you guys see him and hear about him. Again, sophomore from Fulton High School, our boys player of the week, Tyler Lee.
Man, it's a blessing. I just keep working hard. Many blessings gonna come. I just love playing basketball. That's all I know. Okay, short term right now, this season, I definitely want to go to state. I want to experience that very well. I want to go to the NBA. Like, that's my dream. I just want to play.
Tyler has his parents here today, as well as head coach head coach Jody Rice. So please welcome them.
Who says quality can't be quick? With all our work done right in store, Express Frame can handle all of your custom framing needs. Same quality, same people, new name. Express Frame in the Commons Shopping Center on North Peters Road.
In 1931, Eccles West started selling Chevrolets in East Tennessee. And 4 generations later, the West Chevrolet family continues the tradition. We're proud of our rich history and Smoky Mountain heritage. We know our customers' needs and understand our role in the local community. Now, we invite you to visit our bright new dealership. And when you're ready for your next vehicle, come see us at West Chevrolet, where we try to treat every customer like a part of the family.
You know, injuries are part of most competitive games, including basketball. It's unfortunate, but there is help available. If you or your young athlete need rehabilitation, check out Prompt Physical Therapy, located next to Lakeshore Park in Bearden. Prompt offers hands-on rehab. The therapists at Prompt Physical Therapy are very skilled. They work with athletes, non-athletes, the elderly, and anyone who has an issue which can be improved through hands-on rehab. Ask your doctor if physical therapy is an option to address your pain, and if so, consider a hands-on approach at Prompt Physical Therapy. Remember, you do have a choice. Now let's hear more from our featured speaker at this week's Big Orange Tip-Off Club Luncheon.
One, to go back to the recruiting process, one of the reasons that, you know, I came in here was because of the culture that Coach Barnes and his staff were trying to build here at Tennessee. And I think the biggest thing that I can take away from my time at Tennessee about Coach Barnes and his staff and his culture is work ethic and attention to detail. And I think it's really big on attention to detail, because we really hold ourselves to a very high standard with whatever it comes to, whether it's class, really being on time, taking care of the little things. There's a lot of things that we really try to hold ourselves accountable for and really try to take care of every single day. And work ethic too, that I think no matter what you do in life, I think Coach Barnes is trying to instill in us not only to be great basketball players, but whenever basketball is done, that the work ethic and the discipline that we've learned here at Tennessee, that we can carry that over to whatever fields we pursue for life after basketball, that all his players will be well-rounded and ready for a hard-working life, that he's instilled in us a hard work ethic and discipline and attention to detail that is going to prepare us for life after basketball. And so I think that's very important. I think that speaks volumes of Coach and his staff, that he's looking out for us in so many ways. What KP and Admiral and Grant and those guys have done, and I've had the privilege of learning from those guys, and especially when I was hurt, I had the privilege of learning from Grant. I was sidelined for a while, and guys like Grant and Kyle and Admiral, those were great guys, as you guys know, great guys on the court, off the court, and they did a great job of kind of setting the tone and setting the standard for what Tennessee basketball is and what it means to be a Tennessee Volunteer and wear a Tennessee basketball jersey. And so I've tried really hard to follow in their footsteps and really keep that standard going. And for me to try to do it for people like Jonas and Brandon, I think is very important. And not to put pressure on myself, but I think it's really important for me and Josiah and VJ, Santi, Olivier, for us guys to really take Tennessee basketball on the standard and to let the freshmen know about it and let them know, like, hey, like, this is the standard, this is what we're about. And so then when we leave, they can have it and they can pass it on to the younger guys. And that's really important for us. I am definitely not in charge of playing rap music in the locker room. If you're standing outside the locker room, you always know when I'm playing music because it's always country music. I usually get about one song a week on there before the guys change it. Pushing P is what is going around, and to be honest, I'm not really sure what it means, but whatever it means, I think we need to keep doing it because it's working. So we're going to keep pushing P. I think that is a rap song, and like I said, I don't know what it means, but the guys love it and we're winning, so we're going to keep doing it. So he asked about the board game Catan. I think it's called Settlers of Catan or Catan, whatever you guys want to pronounce it. And it's a board game that Grant Williams was pretty famously known for, and he carried it. They played it in the locker room all the time. He carried on road trips, and honestly, I never played Catan. I don't know how to play it, but Grant and Lucas Campbell and Brad Woodson and Brock Jancic, those guys were really big on it. It was an essential when we went on the road. They played it every night, and it's not as easy as, you know, like Sorry or Monopoly. It's pretty, I guess you got to use your mind and think about it. Like, you got to collect like brick and wood and hay and sheep and all this stuff. So definitely some thought that goes into it, but I never got into it. And honestly, it has since left the program since Grant left. And so I'm not sure Grant would be too happy about that because he worked really hard. Like I said, he brought it everywhere. And I guess when he left and Lucas Campbell left our program, that Catan did as well.
Take a tour of Big Orange basketball history at the Hoops Museum in North Knoxville. This nonprofit collection preserves UT men's basketball memorabilia. Historian R. Larry Smith shares more than 100 years of Vols, including the Ray Mears era, to today's team. Displayed are dozens of vintage Tennessee artifacts. Hoops Museum tours are free. Just bring a game program, ticket stub, or sports page to help R. Larry Smith round out this historic tribute. Phone 865-679-4106 to plan your Hoops Museum visit.
Hi, I'm Joel for Knox Rail Salvage. Our products are installed all over East Tennessee, and they speak for themselves. For over 37 years, East Tennesseans have trusted Knox Rail Salvage to deliver a quality product at a fair price. Whatever your dream home is, we have a product for every taste and every budget. Our selection is unmatched in East Tennessee. Thanks for listening, and remember, come see us at Knox Rail Salvage. We're making home improvement affordable.
Tom Spangler, Knox County Sheriff, grew up in East Knox County. He's a graduate of Carter High School and an Air Force veteran who began his career in law enforcement as a corrections officer, working his way through the ranks from patrol, metro narcotics, training director, chief deputy, and overwhelmingly elected sheriff in 2018. Now with over 40 years of experience, Tom Spangler is running for re-election.
I'm Tom Spangler, your current Knox County Sheriff, and I'm running for re-election, and I'm asking for your vote.
I think the most I've learned is Spanish, especially whenever Santiago got here. He was pretty new to this language, to this country, and so I really tried to be a big brother to him and really tried to take him in. And Like, for example, we would, after games and after practice, one of his favorite places to go was Cookout. He would always want to go to Cookout. I would take him there a lot when he first got here. So, but with Santi, I've learned a little bit of Spanish, and one of the words I've learned is cachate, and cachate means shut up. And so whenever he's talking, or especially in Spanish to one of his friends, or just whenever I feel like messing with him, I'll just yell that at him, and he'll just look at me and smile. So that's pretty cool. I guess when I went in the past and I was actually having to pay for my food, then I would have to really be kind of, I guess, decisive on what I got because I was having to pay for it. But now, I guess the past few months, I've kind of branched out on the menu and I've been able to try different things. But I would say probably my favorite thing is probably just a hot dog with chili. I really enjoy those. Those are really good. Their Frenchie fries are really good. And then I'm a big sweet tea person. If I could, I would drink sweet tea all the time. But I know it's not healthiest for you, but their sweet tea is very good. I graduated last year with my degree in sports management, and now I'll graduate in this May with my master's in communications. And where I see myself from a year now is playing basketball, wherever that may be. Wherever God leads me is where I'll be. And then 10 years from now, well, I'll be 10 years from now, I want to be married. I want to have, I'll be 35. So I want to have probably at least one, two kids maybe. I want to have a family one day. I think I want to call Knoxville home. I've really grown to love this city and this community, even though I'm from Kingsport. Kingsport would be a great place too. I want to have a family, some kids. I'm not sure what I want to do yet with my post-basketball career, but I guess I'll figure that out when the day comes.
Let's give him a hand.
John, you're talking about where you're going to be 10 years. Andy, he's going to need some insurance is what I see he's going to need. Coach, anything that he left out?
Yeah, if John decides if and when to shoot a three, he makes it. You guys tell Coach Barnes it was my idea. If he misses it, he was the one who wanted to shoot it.
John, do you have a few minutes? And Coach, you have a few minutes that after us people, I know they won't come up and have their picture made with you, anything. If y'all have got a few minutes, stick around. Next week, we've got Al Brown, so you've made it a good day for us already, for both of you. So thank you. And John, a year from now, we'll still be here every January and February. So every Wednesday. So come back. If you call Knoxville home, you keep coming back. We've got a lot of former Lettermen out in the crowd here. So this will be your home. So go out and make it a good day. Thank you.
It's time to shut her down for another weekend. Thanks for watching Tip Off Lowdown. Have a great weekend, and we'll see you at the game.
Tip-Off Lowdown with the Big Orange Tip-Off Club is brought to you by Prompt Physical Therapy next to Lakeshore Park in Bearden, and by the Re-Elect Tom Spangler for Knox County Sheriff Campaign Committee. Re-Elect Sheriff Spangler.